out, O Lord our God. Christ our Lord. Today is the third Sunday of Advent, and we will light the candle of joy. Last Sunday we lit the candle of peace. We light it in the candle of hope again as we remember Jesus, born in Bethlehem, our hope and our peace. Today we light the third candle of Advent, the candle of joy. In their old age, God gave to Zechariah and Elizabeth a son called John. John spoke to the people bravely in the desert, denying his own comforts and prepared to die for what he believed. John taught that we should share what we have with others, treat each other kindly, and show God's love. He did this because he cared for people and wanted them to repent and find God's forgiveness. Joy is like a candle shining in the dark place. As we look at the light of this candle, we celebrate the joy that God answered the prayers we have in Christ. Let us pray. Lord, you witnessed John the Baptist grew up strong in spirit and prepared people for the coming of the Lord. He loved your people and baptized them in the River Jordan to wash away their sins. Help us to have the same love, that we would be witnesses to him and spread the good news of your love. As Christmas draws closer day by day, help us to be ready to welcome him. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I will go unto the altar of God. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, please be seated. Let us confess our sins to God and prepare ourselves that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. And now, please make an examination of your conscience. And now, let us recite together the second form of the act of confession. I confess to Almighty God, one in the Holy Trinity, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned in thought, word, and deed, by my fault, by my own great fault. I ask the Blessed Mother Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray in me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant us pardon and absolution in the remission of our sins.
Amen.
May our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me by him, I absolve you of your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Wait. O God, you will again renew us. Show us your mercy, Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Take away our sins from us, Lord, so that we may enter the Holy of Holies with purified hearts through Christ our Lord. Will you be angry with us forever? Drag out your anger for all generations. Please give us life again, that your people may rejoice in you. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Eternal Father, we joyfully approach the celebration of your Son's birth. May he bring us pardon and freedom from the burden of our sins. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Zephaniah the prophet. Shout for joy, O daughter Zion. Sing joyfully, O Israel. Be glad and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has removed the judgment against you. He has turned away your enemies, the King of Israel. The Lord is in your midst. You have no further misfortune to fear. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, fear not, O Zion, be not discouraged. The Lord your God is in your midst, a mighty Savior. He will rejoice over you with gladness and renew you in his love. He will sing joyfully because of you, as one sings at festivals. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm is from Isaiah, and the response is, cry out with joy and gladness, for among you is the great and holy one of Israel. God indeed is my Savior. I am confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. With joy you will draw water at the fountain of salvation.
Cry out with joy and gladness, for among you is the great and the holy one of Israel.
Give thanks to the Lord. Acclaim his name among the nations. Make known his deeds. Proclaim how exalted is his name.
Cry out with joy and gladness, for among you is the great and holy one of Israel.
Sing praise to the Lord for his glorious achievement. Let this be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
Cry out with joy and gladness, for among you is the great and holy one of Israel.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. Your kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will save the lame and assemble the outcast. I will give them praise and renown in all the earth when I bring about the restoration. Alleluia, alleluia. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given you besides.
Alleluia.
Almighty and eternal God, who cleansed the lips of the prophet Isaiah with a burning coal, cleanse my heart and my lips through your gracious mercy, that I may worthily proclaim your holy gospel through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Lord be in my heart and on my lips, that I may worthily proclaim his holy gospel. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. The crowds asked John the Baptist, "What should we do?" He said to them in reply, "Whoever has two cloaks should share with the person who has none, and whoever has food should do likewise." Even tax collectors came to be baptized, and they said to him, "Teacher, what should we do?" He answered them, "Stop collecting more than what is prescribed." Soldiers also asked him, "And what is it that we should do?" He told them, "Do not practice extortion. Do not falsely accuse anyone, and be satisfied with your wages." Now the people were filled with expectation, and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, "I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his barn. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." Exhorting them in many other ways, he preached good news to the people. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praised by all of us now and forevermore. Amen. Ye bench of Apollonius is Christus. When the messengers of John the Baptist had left, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. These words are taken from the Gospel according to Luke. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. My dear brothers and sisters, on this third Sunday of Advent, we again read of the person of John the Baptist. Scripture tells us that John was 6 months older than Jesus, and that they were related as cousins. We also read in Holy Scripture that John had a special mission from God to announce the coming of God's anointed one. Jesus refers to John as the prophet Elijah in Matthew 17:13. John was a great teacher who had many disciples. His message was simple: prepare the way of the Lord. John the Evangelist describes him in the beginning of his gospel account as one who was to bear witness to the light that all might believe. It is also believed that some of the apostles of Jesus were disciples of John. But it is John who declares in John 3:30, he, Jesus, must increase, but I must decrease. John points out the distinction of their two ministries as recorded in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 3, verse 11. I am baptizing you with water for repentance, but the one who is coming after me is mightier than I. I am not worthy to carry his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. But what does Jesus have to say in testimony about John? We read in Luke 7:24, when the messengers of John had left, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. What did you go out to the desert to see? A reed swayed by the wind? What did Jesus mean when he used the phrase, a reed shaken by the wind? In biblical understanding, a reed shaken by the wind is a person who is blown about by every wind of doctrine. In Ephesians chapter 4, verses 14 and 15, St. Paul writes about this when he says, so that we may no longer be as children, tossed by waves and swept along by every wind of teaching arising from human trickery, from their cunning in the interest of deceitful scheming. Rather, living the truth in love, we should grow in every way into Him who is the head, Christ Jesus. John the Baptist spoke with conviction, for he was filled with the Holy Spirit. In Luke chapter 1, verse 15, we read, for he will be great in the sight of the Lord. He will be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from his mother's womb, and he will turn away many of the children of Israel to the Lord their God. Jesus then asked, then what did you go out to see? Someone dressed in fine garments? Those who dress in luxury and live a high light are found in royal palaces. What did Jesus mean when he used the phrase, dressed in soft raiment? The courtiers, as well as the pseudo-messiahs, would dress in eloquent clothing so that they could draw people unto them. John was uncontentious. His attraction was not what he wore, but what he said. I recently read of a pastor of a megachurch in South Carolina who recently bought his wife a $200,000 Lamborghini for their 8th anniversary. I've also read of a pastor who lives in a $10 million mansion. And I've also read of a televangelist who wanted his parishioners to pay for his $54 million private jet, which is his fourth. I think of John, a simple and humble man, living a simple life, but yet having a most important mission from God. And then Jesus asks again, "Then what did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom Scripture says, 'Behold, I am sending you a messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way before you.' I tell you, among those born of women, no one is greater than John." And so, as we light the third candle of Advent, the candle of joy, we call to mind that God was to answer the longings and the expectations of his people by sending John the Baptist, who was to usher in the Messiah, the Lord Jesus, into the world. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who to God is the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. A man named John was sent from God. He came for testimony, to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. brothers and sisters, that our gifts of love and sacrifice may truly be accepted by God, our Heavenly Father. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, prepare our hearts to receive your Son, the gift of life and peace, who will become present in this sacred offering. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God.
It is right to give Him thanks and praise.
Father, all powerful and ever living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. For through the promise of sending Jesus Christ to earth for us, you revealed your goodness and unending love. Sharing in the hope of the patriarchs and prophets, may we worthily prepare a dwelling place in our hearts for the coming of Messiah into our world. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating very humbly.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Most merciful Father, we most humbly pray and ask you through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, to accept and to bless these gifts, these presents, these holy and spotless sacrifices, which we offer to you in the first place for your holy Catholic Church, that you would guide it in peace, defense, and unity throughout the whole world with its bishops and priests, especially Anthony, our Prime Bishop, and Paul, our Bishop. And all who profess the true Orthodox and Catholic faith which comes to us from the Apostles, remember your servants, O Lord. And of all here present whose faith and devotion are known to you, for whom we offer, who offer up to you the sacrifice of praise for themselves and all their own, for their hope of salvation and deliverance, and who freely choose to serve you, the living, eternal, and true God, we join in communion with and honor above all others the memory of Mary, the glorious Virgin Mother of our Lord and God, Jesus Christ. Also, your blessed apostles, martyrs, and confessors, together with all the countless number of saintly men and women of all nations, but especially of our nation, who lived, suffered, and died for the glory of your name and the coming of your kingdom. May the remembrance of these praiseworthy people encourage us to follow their heroic example, making us worthy of your grace and love, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We ask you, Lord, to graciously accept our offering and that of your whole family, and so order our days in your peace, that we may be saved from spiritual damnation and counted among the flock of your chosen people, through Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, we ask you to bless, to accept, and to confirm this offering, and to make it pleasing to yourself, so that it may be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit and become for us the body and the blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. The day before his suffering and death, in order to manifest his infinite love to his disciples, and through them to all who would believe in him, to fill the hearts of his followers with the fire of this love, draw them to himself, make them joyful, and save them. He instituted these holy mysteries, both spiritually and bodily in his entire being. He again lives among his people. At that solemn moment, so sacred for the whole human family, our Savior took bread into his holy and venerable hands, and having lifted his eyes to heaven, to you, his almighty Father, giving thanks to you, he blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you." In like manner, after supper, taking this excellent chalice into his holy and venerable hands, again he gave thanks to you, blessed it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do these things, do them in remembrance of me." Therefore, in remembrance of this Christ, your Son, our Lord, in his blessed passion, resurrection, and his glorious ascension, we, your servants and faithful people, offer to your divine majesty from your own gifts and presents a pure offering, a holy offering, an immaculate offering, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to regard these offerings with favor and joy, and accept them as you receive the gifts of your just servant Abel, the sacrifice of our patriarch Abraham, and that which your high priest Melchizedek offered you, a holy sacrifice in the immaculate host. We humbly ask you, Almighty God, command that this offering be brought by the hands of your holy angel to your high altar into the presence of your divine majesty, that we, who receive the most sacred body and blood of your Son from this altar, may be filled with every blessing and grace through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and now sleep in peace. To these souls, Lord, and all who rest in Christ, grant, we pray, a place of refreshment, light, and peace through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. And grant us, your sinful servants, who hope in the greatness of your mercy, some part in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, and all your saints who shed their blood for your name. Their hearts were always open to justice and mercy, and with lives patterned after their divine master, merited eternal joy. Number us in their company, Lord, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Christ our Lord. Amen. By whom you always create, sanctify, revive, bless, and freely give us all these good things. Through him, with him, in him, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Pray, instructed by our Savior's teaching, have been following divine example, we say with confidence,
Our Father, who art in
heaven.
deliver us, Lord, from all evils, past, present, and future. And by the intercession of the blessed and glorious Mother of God, Mary, together with your blessed apostles, Peter, Paul, also Andrew, and all the saints, grant us peace in our day. Supported by the help of your mercy, may we always be free from sin and secure from all disturbance. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
May this commingling and consecration of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ help us to receive it to everlasting life. Amen.
Amen.
God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free us from all our sins and from every evil. Keep us faithful to your teaching and never let us be parted from you, who lives and reigns God forever and ever. Amen. May the partaking of your body and blood, Lord Jesus, not be cause for our judgment or condemnation, though we are unworthy to receive the great sacrament, through your loving kindness may become our safeguard and healing remedy. Our saving Master, awaken in us a living faith, fervent love, worship, adoration, and a holy longing. Through this communion, make us your willing servants, zealous to fulfill your holy will. May it at last unite us entirely with you, our Lord and our God. Grant this who lives and reigns with God the Father, in unity with the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. I will take the heavenly bread, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body of our Lord Jesus Christ preserve my soul unto life everlasting. Amen. What shall I return unto the Lord for all the graces he hath rendered unto me? I will take the chalice of salvation, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. With high praise will I call upon him, and I shall be saved from all my enemies. May the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ preserve my soul unto life everlasting. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Lord,
I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed.
Receive the Lord.
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 Rece
gives sight to the blind. The Lord raises up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord protects the stranger, sustains the orphan and the widow, but thwarts the way of the wicked. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Lord our God, we thank you for the coming of your Son in this Holy Eucharist. Open our eyes to the needs of the sick and the poor, for unless we see him in our brothers and sisters, we will never recognize his final coming. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the tribute of our worship be pleasing to you, most Holy Trinity. Grant that the sacrifice which we, the unworthy, have offered up into the sight of your majesty be acceptable to you. Through your mercy may be effective for ourselves and for all those for whom we have offered it. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Almighty and merciful God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. In the beginning was the Word was in God's presence, and the Word was God. He was present to God in the beginning. Through him all things came into being, and apart from him nothing came to be. Whatever came to be in him found life, life for the light of men. The light shines on in the darkness, a darkness that did not overcome it. There was a man named John sent by God, who came as a witness to testify to the light, so that through him all might believe. But only to testify to the light, for he himself was not the light. The real light which gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and through him the world was made. Yet the world did not know who he was. To his own he came, yet his own did not accept him. Any who did accept him, he empowered to become children of God. These are they who believe in his name, who were begotten not by blood, nor by carnal desire, nor by man's willing it, but by God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory of an only Son coming from the Father, filled with enduring love. Thanks be to God. Jesus Christ be praised by all of us now and forevermore. Amen. Nik bencha paphalon Iesus Christus. My brothers and sisters, I welcome you to church on this day. I bring to mind some of the announcements. Following this Mass, we have scheduled a fellowship hour. Also, downstairs, if there are any other donations to be made for our Adopt a Family, please see Teresa Girardi. All of these gifts will be taken over to Holy Family this coming Friday. I didn't have a chance to talk with one of the coordinators, and so we will be bringing the presents over then. I bring to mind tomorrow, Monday, December 17th, 7 o'clock p.m., monthly meeting of our parish committee. I bring to mind on Friday, December 21st, is the Feast of St. Thomas, the Apostle. Holy Mass of the Eucharist will be said. Also, as you notice in the bulletin, every morning at 9 o'clock, Holy Mass is said here at Holy Name of Jesus. Invitation is sent out to all. I bring to mind next Sunday, December 23rd, fourth Sunday of Advent, Holy Mass at 9 o'clock. Also next Sunday, I'm happy to announce that Liam Kenneth Spatcher will be presented unto the Lord and baptized in the living waters. And so I extend an invitation to all to attend. Also, we are scheduled next Sunday to begin the preparation for the Christmas holiday, and I'm going to ask for help and assistance with that. Aquatic is also available in the vestibule of the church, as well as the 2019 parish envelopes. I wish to thank all who participated in last week's Christmas party. A special thanks to the members of the Ladies' Adoration, as well as others, and I bring to mind Cindy Benjamin, Lynette Poe, and anyone that I may have forgotten to mention. I do bring to mind, I had a chance to talk with John Siz yesterday, and that I will be seeing John on Tuesday at 10 o'clock with the donations for all the hats and for the gloves that have been collected. And again, I want to thank Cindy Benjamin for her help on this. I happen to notice, Peg, we're pretty much out of pierogi. There are a couple dozen pierogis that are left. Peg?
We are all sold out of cheese. We have a dozen and a half cabbage left and 9 and a half dozen potato and cheese. So if you want any for Vivia, that's all we have. And please get them today. We were scheduled to be open next Saturday, as we have been all Saturdays in December, but we will not because there's not enough for people to purchase. So please see me after Mass if you are interested in what we have left.
Thank you, Peg. Between the advertisement in the newspaper and also advertisement on the local channel, and through word of mouth, I'm very happy to announce that we've done quite well. Our labors have been answered, and that I'm sure that all the pierogi will be gone by next weekend. I also happen to notice that the sign was taken down, because I know I've had people that have already called since yesterday asking about pierogi. I mentioned that we're basically out of them. I do bring to mind donations for Christmas flowers being taken. I was decided at one of the recent Ladies Adoration Society meetings that this year would be purchasing artificial poinsettias. But I know that there are those who have donated and those that are considering donating. So please, if you can, please donate toward the Christmas flowers, and a list of those donating will be published in the coming weeks. I also bring to mind that early part of this week, Monday or Tuesday, I will be sending out the Christmas schedule by mail, as well as by sending it out via the email for the listing of all services that will be taking place during the Christmas season. Is there any other announcements I failed to mention? Then I ask that you remember in prayer those who are sick, those that are having difficulties in their lives, and that through your intention, through our intention, before the altar of God, that God would give grace and peace and blessing unto all. And before I conclude, Let us pray. Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, ever faithful to your promises and ever close to your church, the earth rejoices in hope of the Savior's coming and looks forward with longing to his return at the end of time. May we prepare our hearts and remove the sadness that hinders us from feeling the joy which his presence will bestow, for he is the Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Father?
Yes.
Could I have a prayer for my mother, Dorothy?
Yes, of course.
Martha. She is at Noble. She's been there since Thursday.
Please let us remember Dorothy, and I will make it a point to see her later today.
She may be going to rehab possibly tomorrow. We're not sure.
Okay. I've known Dorothy for many, many years in my dealings with Westfield, and even before then, Dorothy has been a standard in the Polish National Catholic Church, and all of our prayers are for her today. Are there any other announcements or requests? Then let us go before God and offer our prayers. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Almighty and eternal God, your Son Jesus taught us that even before we ask in prayer, you know what our needs are. Therefore, dear Father, you know our hearts and our minds, and so we offer our intentions for the sick, the suffering. We pray for those who are less fortunate than us. For these and all other intentions, may we pray as our blessed Lord taught us, saying, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. And for the repose of our faithful departed, eternal rest grant unto their souls, O Lord. May they all rest in eternal peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.